Yes, that's a couple of cell calls on Indigo this morning. Kunal, what are you adding to the list?
So it's a sell on Tata Power. That stock has also shown signs of weakness. You know, earlier it was more of a range bound stock, very low beta, trendless in terms of the direction of the prices, and just about moving very close to this 200 moving average, 4-5 rupees up, and I think 5-6 rupees on the downside was the tight range for Tata Power since the last so many months. But the stock has now clearly broken out of that range on the downside. It's broken crucial supports along with it as well. Now I believe the stock will open fresh legs on the downside. So sell with a near-term target of 55 and stop is to be kept at 62.
Right, Kunal. Let's welcome in a very special management. Now the management at Tata Power is now with us. Mr. Sinha, CEO and MD at the company, is with us on the phone line. So firstly, thank you so much for taking our time for us. It's been a tough environment for power companies, especially with the worry of coal availability, DISCOM stress. How are things moving? How would you rate the quarter that has gone by in backdrop of such a tough environment?
Thank you for having me on the call. Yeah, the power sector has been going through a lot of challenges, and there have been issues in terms of the DISCOM's ability to pay, and some of the new things which have come up, especially in the renewable space, about the Andhra government trying to reopen some of the PPAs. So, yeah, the sector is in challenge. As far as Tata Power is concerned, we had a good quarter. Our revenues were up, our EBITDA was nearly 29% up, our profits were up, especially on a like-to-like, if we consider it was up by nearly 29%. So this has been a good quarter for us, a lot of consolidation that we have continued to do. We are still very focused on deleveraging our balance sheet, and divestments are in progress. We have already kept two of our foreign assets for sale, and we are progressing well in all those areas.
Mr. Sinha, what's the ambition and roadmap for setting up EV charging stations across the country? We've been hearing some news on that. Do you also see meaningful revenue from this vertical? You know, how do you intend to charge for the EV stations?
The EV charging is a new business area for Tata Power, and we are trying to play an end-to-end role wherein we would provide the EV charging. We would also arrange for the power that is required, especially it would be intermittent and sometimes very large quantity of energy that would be required. And also the customer experience in terms of the software that needs to be provided. So we are very bullish about it. We feel there is a great opportunity both for home charging, which individual car owners will typically have, and also public charging. And also there would be some charging facilities which will be for any of the bus charging or fleet owners who would be having. So we feel quite excited about it. But I think the important aspect in this is the penetration of electric vehicles that requires to be seen, and I think that's a little bit of a slow starter in terms of the penetration. Hopefully in next 2 years we expect large number of electric vehicles will come, and then the consumer will be having a choice of buying those.
When did you say that you'll have the EV charging station set up ready, Mr. Sinha? I missed that.
Yeah, we will have the EV charging stations. We already have nearly 65 of them in Mumbai, Delhi, and in Hyderabad. And we are looking at expanding. Last week we started in Pune also. So we are quite gung-ho and excited about it. But it depends how quickly the electric vehicle penetration takes place.
But the sense that we're getting is, I think, that both go hand in hand. But anyway, tell us a little bit more about the Mundra UMPP as well. How are discussions with various state governments and state discoms progressing? And when can we expect a resolution, and post that a CERC resolution?
The Mundra discussions have been going on very well. There is a general acceptance by all the state governments. And this was evident when a meeting was convened last month on 17th of July by the Union Power Secretary, in which all the state power secretaries were there, all the five state power secretaries and the DISCOMs heads. And in the meeting, all of them said that they want this power. Even with the revised tariff, this will continue to be very low-cost power, and it will be in the merit order. So it is in interest of everyone that this plant continues to operate, and they are all very keen to sort this out. It requires administrative approval of the state governments, and there is a process in which it has to be cleared, not only by the energy department or the state power department, but also by finance and the state cabinet. It is going through the rounds. You can that much push and expedite it. The states have their own priorities. But the good news is that, yes, all the states are looking at it positively and they are on board to do it.
Key drivers for EBITDA growth in the quarter. There has been a significant improvement in Mundra losses. How has renewables done in this particular quarter gone by?
Mundra performance has been very good. From last year, average under recovery of nearly 94 paisa, we came down to 55 paisa. And this has been possible. One is, of course, the softening of the coal prices, but also because we have taken a huge amount of effort in terms of sourcing of coal, in terms of blending of coal, and we expect that many of these will get institutionalized and will continue in future too. We also expect our other businesses to do and continue to do well. Our renewable business, we have seen that the EBITDA has increased by nearly 15% in this quarter. So all our existing operations, our generation businesses in Maithon and in Mumbai, our transmission and distribution business in Delhi and Mumbai, all of them continue to do well, and we expect that the performance will continue in the subsequent quarters also.
Okay, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Mr. Sinha, and taking us through the latest there. Okay, a quick look at what else is catching our eye, hot off the press this morning in the Economic Times. SBI, and we also spoke